Hello everybody, welcome back. In this video we're going to look at a new chart type, and actually it's a chart type we already know. It's a column chart, but we use it in a very special way so that we very easily can compare actual and budget in just one column. So it looks like this, and let's see how we can create this in Excel. So we're back in our dashboard. And we go to the sales slide. Almost no data because we only have two numbers. We have the actual sales or the actual revenue and the budget revenue. And that's what I select. And I'm going to say insert. And in this case, a column chart. Now, what I need, the trick I want to do, and maybe we have an example over here, is I want to move this one behind that one. But I only can do that if this is a separate series. And now it's one series with two categories, so we have to change that. And you can do this with this magic button. So I go to the chart tools, design, switch row and column. And if I do that, I immediately see that are two different ranges. Now we're going to change this one in the ugly but good readable color. There we are. We get rid of the title. And now we have to move them behind each other, and we have to do a trick for that. I'm going to select the actual series, right mouse click, format data series, and I'm going to say, okay, you have to display this series on the secondary axis. And now you see they are just behind each other. But imagine that my budget would be lower, then I wouldn't see it. So somehow I have to make the actual bar or the actual column smaller, and we can do that by using the gap width. So I will make this one 200 and I will make this one 50. So this is kind of okay, but my budget is lower than my actuals and here it's higher. And that's because of we have two different axes and the scale is different. And for years now I'm waiting for Microsoft to somehow automate this, but they don't do that, so we have to do it ourselves. So I'm going to select this file, this axis, and I'm going to say the total should be 6 million. And I do exactly the same over here. So I have new values over here, and now I have two exactly the same axes, and now we can see that budget indeed is lower than actual. So this has no function anymore, we can get rid of it. I don't need the grid lines, get rid of that. But I don't like these large numbers, so I'm going to change the number format of it. We can do that over here, number, and we saw a little of this, we saw it also in the last week. We can work with a custom number format. There we are. And in this case, I'm going to say with a 1000 separator at the end, and actually I need 2 because I want to have it in millions. So now I have it in millions. I don't need this one, we can get rid of it. There we are. And now I'll just have to adjust the format. And here we have another trick, because if we look at our dashboard, we now need over here three separate charts. So it should be a little bit smaller. It should be again 2.15 high, but now 0.76 width. And I need some kind of axis, so I'm going to say over here that I want tick marks outside the major level. And now I have a very nice chart. Of course, it's still filled. We don't want that. We want to control that ourselves. So we change that. And we cut that. And we're going to paste that in our dashboard. And there we are. And this was sales. So we have done that now for one chart. We could very easily do that also for the operating profit and the margin, as you can see on the slide. But that's something you can do yourself. For each video, the file we're working on, you can download it from there. And even if you have skipped a file, we make sure that every time you have a file with exactly the right starting point to do this exercise. So you can do it yourself and you can try to get the other two charts in. So what will be in the next video? We have created such a chart in a vertical position, but we also can create it in a horizontal position. And that will be in the next video. See you then.